That is Al Johnson with It's Carnival Time, and Carnival is now officially over. But hey, in New Orleans, we had that spirit all year long. And I'll tell you who else has that spirit, the Southland Conference in baseball. My goodness, I've had Paul Maneri, LSU's coach, on many times, but I keep thinking about every time I'm watching Southland Conference baseball, I'm like, this is the conference on the rise. They've had the last three coaches of the year, all guys that are from our conference in this region. They've had three straight, Southeastern had three straight players of the year, but Nicholls has been rolling for the eighth year. This head coach that we're about to have on, Seth Thibodeaux, has been the head coach of Nicholls. He got the job like Riser did when he was 29 years old. There's so many young guns, but at 37, he's actually become one of the older guys and certainly one of the most tenured. His name is Seth Thibodeaux, and it's his first time on Primetime Sports. Hey, I got to tell you, Nicholls just shoved that door down because I haven't had much Nicholls on for the first 2 years. We had Thibodeaux, the head coach of, I should say, in Thibodeaux, Tim Rebo on last year, but we had him on back in December. We had Richie Riley on 2 weeks ago, and here he is, Seth Thibodeaux, the baseball coach at Nicholls. What's going on down there, man?
There's a buzz in Thibodeaux. Things are, I guess, the new thing in Thibodeaux is the kernels are popping. So
The kernels are popping. First of all, I have to get this straight before we start. You're Seth Thibodeaux. You spell it T-H-I-B-O-D-E-A-U-X, like we always say. Yeah. Thibodeaux is always kind of threw me for a loop because it's A-U-X with no E. Right. Which one of y'all is right?
Well, I'm going to go with the intelligent Thibodeaux's had an E in their name. So, but the original Thibodeaux was Thibodeauxville, and they had an E in the name. So, they
took it out,
shaved off the E
later.
They
shaved it off? Okay. Because for a while when I first moved back, I was misspelling it, and somebody's like, it's just A-U-X. Right. I'm like, oh, okay. So all those Go Tigers things, I got to take the E out now.
That's right.
You've been there for 8 years.
Yeah.
Talk about from the beginning to where you are now when you took over this program, because I've watched – what Tim Rebo's done straight up. It's only been 2 years. You've been there a good bit longer. Tell me the progress this team has made.
It's been quite a journey. Just starting out with NCAA sanctions, we weren't fully allotted with scholarships at the time. We weren't at 11.7, we were at 8. Winning 10, 12 games was the norm at the time. And to change the culture, it's been step by step, but it's been done with, Louisiana kids. It's been done with help from Louisiana resources, and it's been a fun journey. And 200 wins later, feel like we've done a great job of graduating our guys and competing for titles here and there and doing some great things in the state of Louisiana.
I mean, listen, the Colonels, like I said, in the other sports, but y'all been the steady Eddie the whole time. I mean, I'm not saying y'all been top of the league every year, but always have great baseball teams, always fight hard. What's the key to your success?
I think just recruiting right and having a culture and a mindset and bringing the right guys into our program, into our university, and having a plan, and sticking to it. And it hasn't been the easiest all the time. Like, no job is, but sustaining the culture has been tough, but we've done it with toughness, and we hope to continue to do so.
Well, we had Richie on literally just 2 weeks ago, and the first thing he said, because I was saying, hey, I think Coach Tibbs is coming up, he goes, that's my guy.
Yeah.
That's my guy. You tell him I said hi. So y'all are both young guys. Yeah, I think he's in his mid-30s,
sure.
Correct? So what's y'all's relationship like?
I think that if you come and work at Nicholls and you live in Thibodeaux, you're going to be a friend of someone or something. And when we work together, Richie's wonderful. I've reached out to him for help. I know when he first got there, I used to go into his office and bring coffee and donuts just to, hey, I've been here. I know what it's like. And so he's an unbelievable talent, and he's going to do amazing things in his career. But right now I'm enjoying every second of him. I actually go watch him practice and pick up some pointers, and I like to listen to him talk to his guys. It's been a treat, and right now they're in first place, and I'm not shocked by it.
I was at the game.
Yeah.
I mean, I got to give him props. I mean, I support all the teams around this area, but I've been to a lot of Tulane and UNO games. They're right here. Of course, I go to LSU a good bit. But, I went to support both coaches in this particular game.
Sure.
And I hated to see one lose, but Nicholls really is a good basketball team.
Yeah.
And all the programs are rolling. And you said it at the start about the Colonels are popping and all that. But there is truly a buzz that I don't ever remember about Nicholls right now.
Everything is happening. Restructuring the football stadium, redoing the basketball arena. We're doing the softball stadium. Baseball stadium is a treat to see right now. It's beautiful. So I think the people there are gravitating towards the support, and we're recruiting well within this 2-hour radius of Thibodeaux, all of us, all the sports. So there is a buzz on campus, and there's Nicholls only fans. Sometimes we have schools in the area that have an LSU fan base and a You don't see much purple and gold on our campus. You see red, and you see people that are proud to wear them with a
sword. Wow, because that hasn't always been the case.
No, it has not, and it really is directed that way. And look, when your football program and your basketball program are winning,
they want to be a part of it.
They want to be a part of it.
Mike D'Attilier, I got to give him props because he has been an ambassador of sorts for y'all as well. I know he knows all you coaches. Right. You know, what's he done for the program?
He's always around. He's been around since day one. He and I met years ago on another, you know, TV or radio station interview right when I got the job. And I remember talking to him. And then all of a sudden, you know, a text message here and a phone call here. And I started inviting him to games and inviting him to banquets. And, we've just kind of became very good acquaintances. And, of course,
he's a good guy.
He's a wonderful guy.
He's a good
He's always around
being.
Campus. It's fun to see him.
Yeah. What's your recruiting base? I'm just curious. Where do you go first? And what's your extension?
I want to stay right here. I want to go from New Orleans to Baton Rouge to Thibodeaux as best we can.
There's so much good baseball,
creep
right?
into Lafayette if we have to.
Yeah.
We'll stay along the Gulf Coast. Mainly Houston to Pensacola. I try not to get out of there too much, but I want these guys here. And last year we signed 10 kids, all high school players, from an hour and a half radius of Thibodeaux. So if we could do that, it's hard to do, but if we can do that, well, I feel like we're going to be in good shape.
Well, first of all, I'm going to segue from there because I was going to start with your star, Kyle Noah, who obviously all Southland DH, who's going to be playing a few positions now. But you have a couple pitchers from Holy Cross and Shaw, I've got to bring up because you just mentioned your recruiting base. We're down here in New Orleans right now. Talk about those guys.
Sure. Well, you know, look, a few years ago we had Justin Sinibaldi from Rummel, who was an All-American.
Right.
And
that's
it kind
right.
of set the tone for our guys. Zach Otem from Shaw, a sophomore lefty that can get up to 91, 92 with a good breaking ball. We're really hoping to see some great things from him. And Kyle Clayton
from Holy Cross
has been outstanding for us just leading up to now. Kyle could be a star for us, but we're really, you know, maybe looking towards him closing as a freshman. He's a warrior, and fears nothing, and so
you can see the way he pitches, right?
Yes.
In that one picture, he looks like a bulldog on the mound.
He is a bulldog, and he competes that way in everything he does. So, perfect fit for us. I'm so proud that he's here. He played for a guy that I coached in college, at Cass Hargis over at Holy Cross. So, Cass really helped us with him, and Cass said he's going to be your type of player. And it's been the truth ever since he set foot on
campus. Let's talk about some of the straws that stir that drink.
Sure.
And Kyle North is obviously, when you're talking about all Southland, and that's a good baseball conference, I got to start there. What's he mean for your team?
Everything. The glue, the team captain. Has fought injury his entire season and probably kept him, you know, his freshman year he had a bum knee and then his, messed up his other knee his sophomore year but ended up hitting 370 his sophomore year. Coming off of an injury, so he didn't play his first two falls with us, his freshman, sophomore year. His junior year, he is rolling and breaks his hamate bone just after a walk-off home run against Brown early in the season and ends up missing a month of baseball, which hurt us a lot. Comes back and does really well, but he's fought injury, and so if he stays healthy, he can be one of the top five hitters that nobody knows about in our league.
Well, they're getting to know about him now.
Sure.
I'm throwing his name out there right here.
There
if he's 1A, I got a 1B and 1C.
Yeah.
You got a second baseman in Ethan Valdez and obviously Gage Tier at first base.
Yes.
Talk about that side of the infield because that's pretty strong.
Yes, Ethan is a second-team all-conference player, probably one of the faster guys on our team, maybe the league. Can really, really run, can play short, second, or third for us in a pinch if we need him to do any of it. And going to be huge for us in the top half of our lineup, can steal bases with the best of them.
Scrappy?
Very defensive player as well, though. If I put him in center field tomorrow, he would be fantastic at it. If I put him on the plate next week, he would figure it out.
He'd figure it out.
But he'll do it for Nicholls.
You need guys like
Absolutely.
That.
Blood and guts type player, our type of guy for sure. Gage Tier was an all-Southland defensive team player last year, only made two errors at third base. It sounds kind of funny, but we're moving him to first base for now. Because he's a hitter. He can bang it pretty good. He also fought an injury last year.
He looks
the
part,
too. Got hit in
the head
against Tulane. He does look the part.
Because Kyle North looks the part, but this dude looks the part.
This guy is a ball player in every way, shape, and form. And can play some first, can play some third, but I really want him to hit that baseball over the yellow line in the outfield. So we're going to try to let him really focus on hitting. He's a plus hitter, and we need a full season out of him. Playing first base might really help him out a lot.
Before I get to some of your other guys, let's talk about you. Where'd you come from? What's your history as a ball player? I mean, there's never been really a baseball player that hasn't played.
Right.
A coach, I should say. Let's talk about your past. Where'd you come from?
Yeah, I'm from Church Point, Louisiana, which is a metropolis over there, booming area.
It's booming.
It's God's country, though. It's
no,
a
I
wonderful
know folks
place.
From Church Point.
Yes.
We'll talk about that later.
Yeah, I'm one of eight kids, and fortunate that I came from a great family and a supportive family. graduated from William Carey. Before that, I was at LSU Union. Yeah. So I graduated there and played some pro ball for the Baton Rouge Riverbats in the Independent League, Southeastern League. So played there, and I was fortunate to have met JRT.
You said the Riverboats?
Baton Rouge Riverbats.
Bats. Okay. Yes. I thought you said something else.
Yeah.
That's kind of below, on the other side. Yeah. I was like, wait up. Okay, yeah. Riverbats. I get it.
Yep. And was fortunate to work with J.R. Teagues at Pearl River for 2 years right after I'm finished with school and playing.
The great Southeastern coach, now athletic director, right?
He did a lot for me in my career. And really, I could not be a head coach right now without his help. And he guided me, and I grew up a lot with him, and I owe him probably the rest of my life for his help and guidance. And I felt like after 2 years there, he took me with him to Southeastern. When he took over at Southeastern there. And so I was an assistant there, and I knew if I don't go figure some things out and make myself, I'm a trial and error guy. If I don't go, I had an opportunity to go to Nicholls. If I don't go teach myself some things in this game, I'm never going to be what I'm supposed to be, in my opinion. So I was fortunate that I was able to get a position at Nicholls, and I was very young at the time. I was hungry to be a recruiting coordinator. I was hungry to, do what I could to be the best. Nicholls was not good at the time. They were winning 10 games a year. But what I saw when I was at Southeastern was how passionate their fan base was when we played there, how full of red when I was at Southeastern, how much red was in the stands. I'm like, this place is neat, and there's got to be something to it. And I remember playing against them in college thinking, I want to be here one day. And it was really neat, and I thought, when I went out, I will never forget, my wife and I walked out in right field for my interview before we were there early, and she elbowed me in the ribs and said, you've got some work to do if you want to do this. And she's seeing reality, and I'm seeing Wrigley Field. I'm thinking of the cooking club outright.
Right, baby.
I'm seeing the changes of the stadium.
Yeah, you're seeing it, right. Look at you.
So it was neat, and it's coming to fruition now. And I remember when we left my interview, I called the shortstop and said, you're coming with me. And I got my first commitment on the way home that day, and that was a neat story that I can carry with me forever. But we took it from a 9-win-a-year program to competing for 30 wins plus every year and having a chance. And our record against the state of Louisiana in the last 7 years is incredible. We have a 600-700 winning percentage against the state of Louisiana.
In baseball, that's fantastic.
Sure. And we've just got to take it to another level. It's part of it, and that's our responsibility this year.
All right, last thing I got. You're not also scared to do whatever it takes to get a great player.
Sure.
Because you were number 7.
Yeah.
And I noticed when I was going through the research, I was like, wait, he's 28 now.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
I remember a young man by the name of Justin Holt was number 7 in high school. He's from Gulfport High School. And I was thinking, man, I got to get this guy. And he was number 7. I said, listen, son, part of this deal is if you want to wear number 7, I have no problem giving it up to you. And so I had to do that for a few years for him. And we had a lot of success with 28. So I thought, I'm just going to stay at 28.
Well, you got a lot of great players. We'll have it on. We'll talk about them later. But I loved hearing the backstory more than anything. So congratulations on what you're doing. You're doing some great things. I have a gift certificate
for
the next time you come to New Orleans. Maybe it's a recruit.
Thank you so much.
It's so good to have you.
Yes.
I do appreciate you very much. This is Seth Thibodeaux. Listen, man, I don't usually do this, but we had a lot of baseball coaches in the last 2 weeks. And I just wanted to start the season off right so you get to know a little bit about the coaches, the people behind, and some of the players as well. So I want to thank everybody. Hope everybody had a fantastic Mardi Gras. I want to thank my other guests as well. Of course, we had Matt Reiser from Southeastern and Cody Worsham. He's another young gun. He just does it in another field. He's with Tiger Rag, and he is the editor, and I want to thank him as well. I want to thank everybody that showed up on Mardi Gras, my producer, Will Hill. Of course, Nyela, who does it all behind the scenes, the Redhead Tsunami, and everybody at WLA and CST. Hope you had a great Mardi Gras. It's time to repent for your sins. All right, we'll see you next week on Primetime Sports.